Mike Sports Vibes. Thank you for vibing with me. The mighty Minnesota Vikings made another good underrated signing by getting Robert Tonyan, tight end. Yes, he played for the Packers. Yes, he played for the Bears last season, had a down season in 2023. But I think it's an underrated pickup. We're also going to talk about the 2024 schedule for the mighty Minnesota Vikings. I'll give you my prediction at the end of the video, but best believe we will make the playoffs. Skol to the bowl. You know the vibes. Make sure you hit the subscribe button and that like button if you haven't already. We'll be doing play-by-play for most of every Minnesota Viking game this upcoming season. So join the YouTube family. But let's get back to Robert Tonyan. And the reason why I think this is underrated, because first of all, I think of TJ Hockenson. When is he coming back? And yes, that's a concern. But this man right here is a touchdown machine. In 2020, this man had 11 touchdowns. He'd been in the NFL for six seasons. And in that season of 2020, he had more touchdowns in that one season than the other five seasons put together. So he's a touchdown machine in the end zone. He makes contested catches. And I don't care if it's J.J. McCarthy. Well, I do care. I want to see J.J. McCarthy play as soon as possible. But if he's not ready, of course, Sam Darnold will be in the game. And I'm hoping Sam Darnold does good. But he, like I said, he's a big target. And he is 6'5", 240 pounds. He's only 30 years old. And he's, like I said, he makes contested catches. Like, it don't matter if he's getting double teamed or anything. Like, he just makes the hard catches in the end zone. And Aaron Rodgers in that year, I know that the Packers won the division. They were 13-3. They was first in the NFC North. I'm not sure if Aaron Rodgers was MVP that season, but I know. You know what I mean? That was his target in the end zone most of the dang on time. He had 586 receiving yards in 2020, and he averaged 11.3 per catch. So, like I said, I'm not going to say it's the greatest move in the world, but this is good because they're being proactive and like, yo, let's go get somebody in here, another tight end in here, because we don't know when TJ Hockenson is going to be ready. So, shout out to Kwesi. He's still cooking, and I'm loving the move. I'm loving it. You know what I mean? But let's get to the 2024 schedule. Let's get to week one. Who do we play week one? Week one, the mighty Minnesota Vikings play the Giants away at Giants. All right, so Daniel Jones, come on, bruh. We're going to win this. This is an easy dub, man. This is an easy dub. Like, I don't see how Daniel Jones has any chance against a Brian Flores defense. This is not Donichel defense. Daniel Jones is going to have trouble. They're not going to have a run game. Saquon Barkley went to the Eagles. So who are they running back? And who are they running back? And also, I do like their first-round pick, Malik Nabers. Debatably, some people think he's the best wide receiver in the 2024 NFL draft. I don't think so. But he is definitely talented, so he has someone to throw the ball to. But I just don't believe in Daniel Jones. I think he's overrated. He got that contract because he went against a Donichel defense. You know what I mean? So that's a dub. That's a dub for us. First dub of the season will be away against the Giants. Week two, we go against the 49ers. Brock Purdy, we got to make him one-dimensional. Easier said than done. Trying to stop that run game. I don't know. I just don't know. And it's at home, first home game of the season. But I just feel like the 49ers are built differently, and I think they're the best overall team in the NFL still to this day. And I just feel like we're gonna lose that game. I mean, I'll be happy if we win, obviously, but like I said, I'm trying to be as realistic as possible. So we're going to be 1-1 in the first two games. All right, who we got week three? Week three, Houston Texans. Now, let me start. When I think of Texans, I don't think of C.J. Stroud right away now. I think of Danielle Hunter. And depending on who our quarterback is going to be, week three could be J.J. McCarthy. I can't wait to see J.J. to J.J. all day. You know the vibes. But I hope, you know what I mean, if Sam Darnold is the quarterback, like I said, I got to keep saying it because I don't want to seem like I'm hating on Sam Darnold. Like, I don't want him to do good. I want him to do good. He's a Viking. I want him to do good. But I'm a little nervous, man, because a Danielle Hunter. I think of Danielle Hunter. I don't think of C.J. Stroud when I think of Texans now. Danielle Hunter was one of my favorite Vikings in history. I loved watching him play. He was one of those players that he didn't get the credit he deserved, man. When he was healthy, he was one of the best defensive ends, hands down, every single year. You know what I mean? Top 10 at least every single year if he played all the games. Top 10 at least. You know what I mean? And I hope the best for him. I hope D-Hunt don't do good against us. Not against us. You come into Minnesota, you're not going to get the dub against us. So we're going to get that dub right there. We 2-1 in the first three games. We're going to apply that pressure to C.J. Stroud. I feel like Brian Flores, Dallas Turner's going to do his thing. You know the vibes. Andrew Van Ginkle, Grenard's going to get revenge. How you going to let me go and then get Danielle Hunter? How you going to do that, man? I think he's going to go off. Jonathan Grenard going to go off that game. So that's a dub. And I feel like, and I'm not going to lie, though, the Texans are built differently. You know what I mean? They built a quality team. Stephon Diggs, they made a trade for Stephon Diggs. Nico Collins is a freaking monster as well. And, you know, if you're a Minnesota Viking fan, you know what Stephon Diggs did for us. And one of the best memories I have had being a Minnesota Viking, the Minneapolis Miracle. So, shout out to Stephon Diggs, but don't do good against us week three. Don't do good against us. But let's get to week four. You know what I mean? Week four. That's a dub against the Packers at Green Bay, bro. That's a dub. We 3-1 in the first four games, bro. I'm not playing around. Jordan Love, I ain't scared of them, bro. I'm not scared of them. I respect them. I'm not scared of them, man. I can't stand a stinking Green Bay Packers. Let's get to the New York Jets. New York Jets, one of the best defenses in the NFL, plus Aaron Rodgers. I think he's going to have an MVP caliber season, in my opinion, if he stays healthy, even at his age. I think he's going to be solid. So I think we're going to lose that game. So we're going to be 3-2 in the first five games. And then we got a bye week six, bro. That is trash, bro. I don't like that. That's too early. Why they got us having a bye week six, bro? Wow. All right, so week seven, we go against the Detroit Lions at home. And I will have the schedule up here somewhere, y'all. We got it. And that's at home against the Jets, too, by the way, week five. So week at home again with the Lions. We're going to get that dub. I respect the Lions. Jared Goff, how the heck did you get that contract? I'm not hating. I'm just stating. He is a quality quarterback. He did. He could have got his team to the dang on Super Bowl. He missed a couple of passes. So I can't hate. You know what I mean? But I don't know, bro. Like, that's a lot of money for him. You know what I mean? Y'all do have a good running game. Montgomery and Gibbs. You do have Hutchinson on the defensive line. McNeil on the defensive line. Y'all secondary got better. Y'all look good team, but I'm not giving you no credit. We going to win this game, man. I don't care, bro. We 4-2, bro. We 4-2. I'm not playing no games, bro. We're 4-2, bro. All right, now we at the Rams. Matthew Stafford. I don't see us losing. I do like they draft in 2024. They drafted Jared Verse. They do got a good running back, Blake Corum. I think that's a great pickup for them. They do got the defensive tackle, Braden, from Florida State. I think he was a good pickup for the Rams. But I don't think they have a chance. They're not winning this game. We're winning this game, hands down. You know what I mean? We 5-2, baby. We 5-2, baby. Like, am I realistic, y'all? Am I realistic so far, or y'all think I'm tripping right now? I just think we're going to beat these teams, bro. Like, all right, so we at week nine. We at home. Colts. I ain't going to lie, man. I liked it. Anthony Richardson. I wanted the Vikings to draft him. You know what I mean? Hopefully he stays healthy, but they have no chance against us. It's not happening. That's another dub. 6-2. No way. Y'all not. No way. Not happening. We're not losing to them. Then we got the Jaguars at Jacksonville, right? I'm going to keep it real, man. Trevor Lawrence, I don't want to say he's a bust, but for him to be the first overall pick a couple years ago, and he had an up-and-down season. He threw for 21 touchdowns, 14 interceptions. he needs to do more for his team to do better. Like, he's not doing the best. We shall see what happens. I think that's a dub, bro. Like, I don't see us losing that game, bro. Like, we're not losing that game. That's another dub, week 10. Come on, man. All right, Tennessee Titans, bro. Will Levis. Do I need to say anything more? Will Levis. That's a dub. That's a dub. I don't, like, Brian Flores is going to have a field day. Dallas Turner is going to be the rookie, defensive rookie of the year. Like, I don't care. Nobody think. I don't care, bro. That's just my honest opinion. I feel like he was the steal of the 2024 NFL draft. And that guy, J.J. McCarthy. I'm not leaving him out. I love J.J. McCarthy. J.J. You know the vibes with that. But Dallas Turner, to get him with the 17th overall pick, bro, he going to get after it. Bro, Brian Flores going to have this dude looking like a superstar year one. Week one. Not even year one. Week one. So, I can't wait. I cannot wait, bro. Get your popcorn ready. Get your popcorn ready for this defense. This defense is going to go, it's going to be crazy. Crazy good. Crazy in a good way. All right, now let's get to the Chicago Bears. At Chicago Bears, I think that's going to be unfortunate. That's going to be an L. You know what I mean? I think that's going to be an L. I think the Chicago Bears draft was amazing. You know what I mean? For them to get Caleb Williams, I feel like that was, like, I think his potential is so high. I respect Caleb Williams, but we'll see what happens. Hopefully, they don't do that good. Hopefully, he ain't an all-time great, because we got to go against them twice a year. I don't want to see that, but then again, it should make us better as a team. And we got J.J. McCarthy, so yeah. But they got a good wide receiver core. DJ Moore, Keenan Allen, and Rome Odunze. I think he's the best wide receiver in the 2024 NFL draft. Maybe I'm crazy. Maybe I'm wrong. People are going to say Harrison Jr., but I just think Odunze is just that dude, bro. Like, he makes every contested catch. He's very fast. He finishes after the catch, meaning when he catches the ball, he breaking tackles. He's getting into that end zone. Speed for days, bro. Like, that was a good pickup. And then the Bears got a real good defense, so I can't even hate. But yeah, that's a L, man. That's an L. All right, let's go to the Cardinals. No comments. That's a dub. Like, I don't even really gotta explain. That's a dub. Like, there's no way we're losing it on, bro. I just don't feel like the Cardinals need to get rid of their quarterback. All right. And then, all right, week 14. This is the big week right here. And I believe, is it away or is it home? Against the Falcons. I'm going to just say this. Kirk Cousins, I don't even know if he's going to be playing at this point. He might fake an injury. He might not want to play us. I wouldn't be surprised if Michael Penix Jr. outplays him or Kirk Cousins doesn't have a good season and they put Michael Penix Jr. in because Kirk Cousins isn't doing his thing. I just have a feeling he's not going to play. Am I tripping, y'all? I just feel like he's scared of the Vikings. I just think he is. And I feel like Brian Flores is going to make whoever the quarterback is, doesn't matter if it's the rookie or if it's Kirk Cousins, first cousin, Captain Kirk, whatever you want to call him, because I just lost a lot of respect for him. You didn't want to be on the Minnesota Vikings. Not saying I wanted him to. I got to keep saying it, because not saying I wanted him to, but he was a solid quarterback. You didn't want to be on the Vikings because of a rookie. That's just crazy to me. Like, come on, man. I just can't respect that, man. I said that in my other video. I just can't respect that. I think that he overrated, bro. He puts up a lot of great stats, but he's overrated. But I like what they have around him. I think Kyle Pitts, their tight end, is a star. Bijan Robinson, you stop their run game, they have no chance of beating us. That's a dub. At home, week 14, there's no way you're coming into Minnesota and beating us. Then we got Chicago Bears. We got the Chicago Bears. Whew, at home. Unfortunately, I think we're going to get swept by the Bears this season, y'all. I know people are going to be like, why would you do that to us, Mike? Why would you do that to us? I'm just trying to keep it as realistic as possible. I just feel like the Bears I think they're going to win the division. That's just my honest opinion. And I think we're going to be right behind them. But we shall see what happens. And that's an L right there. Week 15 against the Bears. And then we got the Seattle Seahawks. Now, Geno Smith re-energized his career with the Seattle Seahawks. I think that their draft was amazing in 2024. Byron Murphy II was a very, very good pickup by the Seahawks. And I think A.J. Barner, tight end, was another good pickup by the Seahawks. They have a very good secondary. I love Julian Love. He had 4 interceptions, their safety, last season. And I love their cornerback, Devon Witherspoon. He had 3 sacks and 1 interception, a very physical corner. He's just I think he could be a great cornerback. That's how much his potential was so high, Witherspoon. And the Seahawks, they just built differently, man. I think they're going to be a good team in that division. Honestly, I wouldn't be surprised if the Seahawks win that division and win it over the 49ers. I wouldn't be surprised. You know what I mean? I think that's an L. At Seattle, that's an L. You know what I mean? So, yeah, that's an L for us. Green Bay. We're not losing to the Green Bay. We're sweeping the Green Bay Packers. There's no way I'm letting Jordan Love do anything against us. There's no way I'm letting that happen. You feel me? It's not happening. That's a dub. You know what I mean? That's a dub. All right. Against the Detroit Lions, week 18. That is a L. And it sucks, man, but it is what it is. It is what it is. We lost that game. So, honestly, I could see us being 10-7 or 11-6, but we're going to make the playoffs regardless. Y'all leave in the comments below and tell me what y'all think. But I think it's going to be a good season. I truly feel like our defense is going to keep us in a lot of these games. Our offense is going to get us together. I just hope that Kevin O'Connell sticks to the run game, and he has to be consistent with it, even if it's not successful. Even if it's not successful early, unless we're behind 20 points or 30 points, keep running the ball. It helps out the whole team. It helps out the defense, getting our defense some rest. It helps out the offense and changes up the pace. It confuses the opposing defense. Play action, screen game, everything works behind that run. Running the ball is what gets you Super Bowls. Even Patrick Mahomes knows that. Even the great Tom Brady knew that. All the great teams, most of the time, they running the ball successfully. You know what I mean? I'm just keeping it 1,000, man. I don't care what anybody says, the running game is dead. No, the running backs might not be valued like they used to be, but they're still very important and crucial to a team's success in today's NFL. So make sure Kevin O'Connell, you run that ball. Quazy, keep on cooking, my guy. Keep on doing your thing. Let's go, Vikings. Skol to the bowl. You know, I'm going to keep saying that. Skol to the bowl. Skol. Y'all let me know what you think. I'm out.